want just to blow EO and Skyrath. Yeah. This is a weird. The drafts both kind of went like, I think, haywire for both teams. They didn't really, it just sort of developed into this. I like drafts like this, though, where things are going sort of, you know, just standard, and then someone picks a whistle all of a sudden, and like, well, we're picking Tiny to block it, and then they're like, okay, what are we doing now? So these are the best kind of games, usually, when teams don't get to do exactly what they were planning. The Naga, I kind of like that, because if they had any other hero that, like, or like, you know, a hero that you would typically combo with Wisp, you just doom the hero that Wisp tethers, and all of a sudden their team fight is like a million times weaker. So I like that really a lot. And Tiny is going to have some troubles, I think. Panda's typically a really good hero against Tiny. He has to get a BKB this game, I think. Or else, but then they have Net for that, and Clockwork Cogs to kind of annoy him, so I don't think Ferrari's going to have a very fun game. Maybe he's going to go for more of a like early game ganking style Tiny because of that. We'll see if he just wants to farm.
It'll be interesting to see if he does, as we have a Clockwork, which I'm pretty sure was modeled on Batman's Bane, or at least the mask for it. It's a very, very freaky mask, guys. What is that? Like, that's the Eternal Machine Head. To battle. Like, does anybody else think of the band? Either way. I guess not. I guess not. I guess everyone's just too young for that. Well, Vici Gaming gonna go to the lane stand. So let's see what we do end up with. So Ice Ice offlane Clockwork, no surprise there. FY as well as Fenrir will be the Wisp as well as Skywrath Mage roaming support combination. I saw this recently, and I think I actually cast that game with you, in fact. And most of the time, we were sitting there just asking ourselves the question, where is the stun? Which, currently, for VG Gaming, they don't really have a lot of those. They have some good ones later on, but... like, in Snare, we'll make sure it definitely goes through BKB. Clockwork, Battery, Assault, as well, it's a little bit more. Oh, this could be a nice little hit. Concussion Shot, still not being leveled up. They're not going to get in front now. They will. And free harassment time into Lua. We went boots first. FY. I think they got this. This should be first blood right now. There's no secondary concussive shot, but first movement blood. Speed, it's enough. First blood's going to be going to the support combination of Wisp as well as Skywrath Mage, killing the offlane Doombringer of Invictus Gaming. He would try to get a little greedy to go into the Radiant, into the Dioxide jungle to grab himself a creep.
Yeah, that's actually pretty... like bigger than usual, I'd say, this game, because with that Wisp, like Skywrath Mage combo, we saw it kind of crumbled last time we watched it because the Skywrath wasn't two for a long time. So that you lose a lot of damage if you don't have the slow and the nuke. You kind of need both to be really aggressive with it. But now that he has both, they can really apply pressure on the map. If they find someone basically that's sort of away from a tower and they just slow and start spamming with orb, I mean, I don't know which like heroes will survive. Enchantress and Lion will both die if they catch them out.
Wasn't it really wise that they didn't put Black in towards the mid lane? Like, would you not be looking for the life points over on the Brewmaster to be up against, like, the burst combo of Tiny? Or do you just not really care because you're going to run bottle for Black and, like, the Mirror Image Riptide should be able to zone out the Tiny?
I think it's mostly that, yeah. He might also just get...
actually,
he's actually doing a lot of damage.
Yeah. Yeah, Ferrari's not too healthy right now, because he still doesn't have that bottle up and running. While Black, well, he's actually still short of his too. They're neck and neck. Now the bottle's coming up for the Radiant side. So Ferrari's got hits on the Courier. Black needs that last, so yes. The Skywrath Mage as well as Wisp, they're rotating again. Spirit Balls, Concussive Shot, as well as Orb Attacks this time around. And well, Luo, he has Scorched Earth this time around, so he will be surviving. But this Doombringer is getting nothing on the top lane. He has to go into his own jungle. There is no other option for him right now. While Ice with his Invis rune, he's just looking to leech a little bit of the experience and maybe cause some problems here for Chispug.
This is pretty rough. They were only able to actually deward one of the camps, the Sob's Ward. For the VG places doing a lot of work, the Sentry Ward barely misses it. And then also their other big camp is blocked still by this sentry. So Enchantress is getting blocked really hard.
They can see him. Ice walked in range of the sentry ward. And now, well, he's out of range, but he's out of invis as well. He's got cogs available, and he's got the space. The enchant not going to slow him down enough. There's still only a half-level Enchantress. But revealed the fact of what they were doing. And, well, Lion expended a large amount of his banner pool for that. That was meant to be a gank on the Naga Siren. It ends up just being a waste of time. And Ice Ice Science gets the bottom lane to one Cog Burnout June and two farm up a creep wave and a half. So he's going to get up to level 4 with this, or practically level 4. Almost.
This is rough. I mean, IG has... There's still level 1 on their Enchantress. They're still going for another smoke gank. He has all of the smokes in his inventory right now. Like, they only have... Well, I guess they have one more in shop because of restock, but... Yeah. They're going on Naga again, but Wisp and Seraph, they're also here. This could end up very, very badly for them. They're actually just, like, walked around each other, basically.
Wisp and Naga heading towards the bottom lane. Black, he's inching up and down the high ground. Now he has to go down the river. He turned back up again, though. And now he's gonna take a fall. Wisp is gonna tether himself in, try and keep Black alive for the moment, while the seal's over on Ferrari, so he can't throw the 4-4 combo to actually bring down Black. I say 4-4, sorry, 3-2 combo. Well, more orb harassment damage from Fenrir, keeping him low. In fact, a lot of these support heroes are very, very low for IG. And with a Riptide, Chuan,
I'm a wet work just specialist.
Giving a free kill to Black. Really not sure about that.
Yeah, I don't think he was gonna die that quickly, but I mean, I don't think he realizes how underfarmed he is at this point. That was kind of really bad, actually. That really sucked that first smoking for IG didn't work
trouble.
Out.
Trouble. Ice, he's able to cock him up with the battery of souls too. June, he tries to double edge, which makes life just actually a little bit easier for VG Gaming. They go 3-0 now here in game number 2.
Definitely IG. I mean, I've noticed that when VG like controls the lanes like this early, they are really hard to deal with for any team. I mean, obviously, they're all very good players in how to use their farm. So, last game we noticed that I guess the Ice kind of won his lane, but for the most part, the lanes went very, very in IG's favor. So we'll see if IG is able to sort of recover this game.
Ice having a lot of fun here with June on the bottom lane. Just moving in and out of the cogs, actually holding the Centaur in position. Now middle lane cuts the shot, goes away Ferrari, and rockets as well. While the tornado is making life very difficult for Black, the fact that Ferrari is still copying this much harassment damage and is getting no progression on his items is a bit of a problem for him. I know he's 26 for 5, but I know. Maybe I just expect too much of Ferrari because he's one of my favorite players.
Come on, Ferrari, do better. No, he's doing okay. The only thing, like, the thing is, it is actually hard for him to kill the Naga because until he has, like, his full burst combo, he can't really blow her up instantly. And now that she has sleep, like, unless he does instantly kill her, she's gonna live. And she also has, you know, she just kind of basically CSs with the Riptide and bottle, like you're saying, so it is pretty hard. He is getting another gank right here, potentially. Chizabug. They're just waiting for the right moment.
There's no perfect lockdown right now on the mid lane. Like, you got Lion to do some work, but that's a Satyr as well as a Hellbear. That's Clap and Satyr Blast.
They also have the tiny combo, though, so if they do get the Hex, I think it should be a kill, but Black just sniffed it out and, yeah, was able to evade that gank. That was really good. That's what you just need to be doing as Naga when you're mid. Be really defensive, because once you start getting your farm later, you can snowball anyways. So if you have to miss like a creep wave or a few creeps because you're just confident that they're coming to gank you, It's worth it. Especially since you already got that kill, so he's already kind of ahead.
Admiral Bulldog in the chat. I'm slightly biased towards Ferrari, yes, but I'm also a huge fan of VG Gaming. And you should come and join us for the next cast. Chat, guilt him into it. He's already been casting with Shiva. And it's off. But no.
Well,
no, yeah, I know that.
We know why that's happening.
special situation. Why no love, Bulldog? Why no love?
He doesn't love you the same way he loves Shiva.
I don't even have him on Skype. I don't even have him on Skype.
Wah wah.
But I'm sure he'll know somebody. Alright. Meanwhile, Super. Wondering if we're gonna have a little bit of fun here with the Doombringer. Because he's already up at high levels. Maybe Ice has been the man having more fun. Chuan, the Centaur is going to be triggering off. Fenrir, though, is in range. And with the cogs, they're going to separate him up. The 10th room from FY, they're looking to bring down June. He's going to hoof stop to start with. Double edge as well. Not enough to get the kill on FY. And he's pinging it out. Ice point blank range hookshot. Try and slow down the Lion's attack and just stall him up. Let's get all out Fenrir, 10th room. But in comes Ferrari. just at the right time, saving Chizbug's life by an inch.
Just and he's gonna get a regen rune. Did he redeem himself for you?
He redeemed himself for me, Ferrari. The man, the moment, the timing. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. And don't worry, it's not the trip sausage, Bulldog. Technically, it'd only be two, because Pandago's probably gonna go to sleep sometime soon. As it is very, very early for him. There's a lot of TPs coming down the bottom lane. Ice, no hookshot available. And the secondary TP is just FY. So there's no control coming out from these support heroes. And that's probably a big question to ask. What do you do once Tiny, Centaur, and Doombringer actually get a little bit bigger? Because you can't just hold them in position and beat them down. The only option you really have is split pushing, but Black isn't getting a huge amount of farm. Like, he's sitting at 3,000 at the moment, but that raid is still going to take some sweet-ass time. While up on top lane, Brimar split. Luo, well, never got the Doom off on him, and, well, actually going to turn around, realizing Fenrir is in a lot of trouble unless that Brimar has turned around to help fight out. So Chizbug, he needs to also back up because his ultimate's running out. They toss the Doombringer in so he can beat down Fenrir. Supers back into his normal self. He's considering a blink into Luo, as Ferrari's already thrown off the avalanche. But he's got another toss available. But he's definitely looking at the rocket, a little bit off target. Got a first rocket brawler hit, which means he'll definitely get the kill. And now tether in from FY. Body blocking up Ferrari as well as going for the spirit balls. Now he's even giving him a toss unit. That's why FY is backing himself away. But the avalanche toss combo will kill off FY instead. And Super will tank up the Doom.
Obviously, we're sacrificing the Wisp to save the Tiny there. Or not Tiny, the Panda, Brewmaster. Sorry. Man, Ferrari's getting some nice runes. Actually, he's not. I totally did not see Black coming there. I was just like watching Ferrari in the screen. It wasn't looking at my mini-map. Well, Black's getting some nice runes.
You're so biased, Pandago. Ice is looking for a nice little hookshot line. Very difficult to get, though, with... Well, they do have their Observer and Sentry down, which is allowing them to see over the river. But when you TP in that obviously in front of the heroes, not going to be as easy. But bottom lane, there's a three-man smoke movement. They must be looking for the jungle heroes. Enchantress and Line are the only one. Actually, no, they got June as well here. RP game to start with, and now, well, jump in, clap over on three. There's no Mystic Flare available, but then Chuan, heist, the perfect hook. It was the perfect clap. Now Centaur with a perfect hook stop. It's just perfection. Double kill from either way. Super will go down. Triple kill for Ferrari. Einstein's battery assault is keeping Luo away. 2 seconds until Cogs, but they'll toss in Luo. He's looking for the last three. The Cogs will now lock him in, pushing Ferrari back a little bit. But VG Gaming, they thought they had it in the bag with that opening. And all of a sudden, Invictus Gaming hit back, and they hit back fast.
Everyone just has like tons of AoE nukes right now, and they're all hitting like three-man AoE nukes. It's pretty funny to watch, just back and forth. Like, they'll hit three of them, they'll hit three of them. And there's not too much they can do about it, though, because at that choke point there, it's just like everyone had to be grouped up to take that fight. Ferrari's been making some really nice TP rotations this game that have really kept IG in the game, though.
This moment from VG Gaming, they're doing it again, but this time around, it's different. Because you get the Mystic Flare, which means they can get themselves the quick kills and then move on to the next target. Yeah. Especially when June is this low, the clamps out of range, but the concussion shot will connect over on June. And the Brewmaster, straight to the split. Didn't even want to wait for anything, but this will allow him to go deeper, picking up Luo, sending him into the air. There's TP support on the way in at the moment. That's going to be Ferrari again, but Luo already low on life. There's no mana for a Mystic Flare. He did it the last moment, but it's too late, and Luo is still alive. Super, back in normal Brewmaster, trying to find a clap, but getting stunned up. Luo knows he's got to be a little bit further away, as now you get yourself a double kill Ferrari. The Doom's off cooldown again, but he's going to Drunken Brawler down. It's not even a Drunken Brawler, just basic attack down Chizbug. But it gives Doom and Ferrari the extra experience, while Ice pick off on the back lines, finds the retreating out Doombringer, and just battery assaults him down. TP, it will be in time. Centaur will not be able to reach him. Nice little snipe off, and that, and I'm not going to say it makes it a perfect even trade, but it keeps things balanced for the moment.
Yep. The thing to keep in mind during all these crazy engagements is Black has been having a very nice, relaxing time, casually hitting creeps. He is actually incredibly farmed for like the fact that he was dealing with all those ganks mid. I mean, I guess he did get the kill mid, so the gank kind of just backfired horribly for IG, but still, I mean, he's got a bottle. He went treads and a magic wand because he didn't was kind of afraid of the tiny combo and getting bursted down, so he just wanted the extra HP. And yeah, he's gonna have a pretty fast relic, probably like 15, 30 or 16 minutes at this rate.
It's gonna be nice for him. It's gonna be nice for their entire team, because it's gonna make it almost impossible for Enchantress and Lion to stay on the front lines, because they're just gonna burn out.
Yeah, and it'll deal with the Blink Daggers too. If Ferrari decides to go for that Blink Dagger combo build, which he might because he's just on such like a tear right now, then like just having the Naga Illusions in team fights or running at people and stopping blinks will be huge. Center is about to finish up his blink too.
Ferrari finished money, but he went for a Yasha to start with, so it looks like we'll be looking at a brawling tiny. So it'll be Yasha into Aghanim Scepter. Just the movement speed for now. Up to 4.
That's so fast. Got drums, Yasha.
Setting up now at 4-3-1 on that movement speed. A little bit of movement coming to bottom lane. June is looking for an initiation by size. He's going to get it too. Quick jump in. He's got the shots going to try and help out, but Fenrir realizes that his teammate is dead. They end a godlike streak of the clockwork. In fact, he was, you know, he must have been 3-for-1. Well, 3-for-2, but 3 kills in a row.
For the Niger, this is definitely the phase of the...
Like, she actually has now 200 away. 200 away from Relic. We have a 15-minute Relic on a Naga Siren, who I thought was not going to get. Like, I was thinking like 20 minutes before you have like the full Radiance up and running.
Yeah, I mean, they haven't really been contesting them at all. That's the thing. They've just been taking these fights. The good thing about VG, I guess the highlight of what's been happening is even though they've been kind of losing out in terms of kills in these fights, they've made them all happen on IG's side of the map, basically, right? I don't think, maybe the only one that would technically be considered their side is at top, but it was like, you know, in lane, like towards IG's tower. So Black's just been doing a good job at staying away. Not even, he hasn't even been coming to help, because some of these fights might have been turned around with like a really good Naga sleep, but it's not really worth the risk. If you can just let your Naga free farm, I mean, and go even in trades, then you might as well do that rather than have the Naga come and potentially have a huge team fight. And he does have his relic and just buy it, but I don't think he's even too concerned about that right now.
Well, we're heading into Roshan in a moment. The Sata was scouting it out for the Radiant side, but VG Gaming, it looks like everyone's grouping up. Prepare yourself for the mid fight. There's still 30 more seconds of this tornado. I doubt VG Gaming really want to have that kind of disadvantage coming into an engagement like right now. The Ferrari, just trying to force the lane up a little bit further. But they're not going to fight just yet. FY still hiding in the tree line here with Ice. That's an easy way for VG Gaming to get in too. Like, you hook shot in, then you get a relocate unit in as well. You've already got the Blink Dagger over on Super. The only thing which I really kind of want to see over on VG Gaming is finally some Arcane Boost for this Skywrath Mage. Because he has got, well, basically, he got himself a Null Talisman.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Half the money.
Another smoke, same thing they've been doing. It looks like they're... Oh, wait, what was that ping for?
They could try and go for a kill. These four guys still, like, okay. VG Gaming still need to make space for Black. Like, he's walking around with this relic as well as 500 AD gold. But they want to find a kill, and then they want to push out a tower. And their goal must have been to get a kill on the bottom lane, and then force out the tower. Now, IG, it's their five-man smoke gank, and they're coming in for Black. So difficult to get though. If they don't jump him instantly with a stun, he's just gonna sleep and TP himself out to safety. And this will waste their entire time. And now sleep. Well, hook stops. There's your stun. Throw him up in the air. They got the kill. The T1 tower will be actually not lost on bottom lane. It'll be traded for instead. Fortification from the Radiant side bought them sometime. But it's a T1 tower for a T1 tower in the mid for the bottom. I don't know if IG will even stop here.
It looks like they're going towards top instead. I'm just trying to collect some tier 1 gold. It's way harder for them to push the tier 2 right now. They don't really have the, like, tower pushing damage. I guess they do have a pretty, like, a level 11 tiny, but still, they don't really have the damage to take on a tier 2 right now, especially with Naga respawning and having sleep up. So it would set up a really bad team fight for them. So I think they will be this year one eventually. They might just have to like sort of slow push it. And they're also just kind of hiding June and stuff. Okay, never mind. He's just like, come and hit the Crimson Lane. Let's get this over with. Yeah, they're all just trading towers right now. Mid towers should go down. Like VG should be able to get this mid tier one very easily. They're just trading all the tier ones.
They got some chip damage into the tier 2 tower in the bottom lane as well. And the Spirit FY moving down there and taking care of that. They're trying to get the last hit to Black, and he does get it, so it brings him very, very close to that Radiance. So we're still 18 minutes in. Tani is the primary hero here of Invictus Gaming. As he's now going in for... Wait, what? Is it just a casual Ogre Club? Or is he considering going into a BKB with the Yasha before going in for the Aghanim Scepter?
I have no idea, to be honest. I don't think BKB is the choice against Naga, but
maybe he's a little worried about Skywrath and the Brewmaster control.
I was saying he does need a BKB this game, but it's still just not even that good. That's the problem. He really doesn't need it. It's actually mostly for the Panda. Like he'll be in the air the whole game if he doesn't have one. He'll either be flying or he'll be drunken haze. So all he'll have is his combo, which is not what they can. They need some right click damage from Tiny this game.
I doubt it's gonna be an SMY boy.
Yeah, he just bought the Mythal Hammer.
Oh, it's gonna be BKB then. But he's basically got the BKB anyway. This last little creep, boom. So 19 minute BKB Yasha and drums for Tiny. And not too shabby at all.
Yep. If you do that on Tiny, like with this build he just went, I mean, that's fine, but you're basically committing to, we need to win the game within the next like 15 minutes, I think, or we're going to be really sad. Because it kills his farming capabilities. I mean, it's still good. He still has his combo and he's still Tiny, but you know, compared to a Naga, it's nothing. He needs an Axe to be able to like, really push out lanes. And I mean, once his BKB gets like 4 seconds, he's just going to get netted during it and then controlled, so he has to use those charges very, very wisely, and they need to take some big fights and get tier 2s with it, or else VG is going to just run away with the game, I think, with the Naga.
I'm just going to ask you the mystery of life. Does this Wisp look invis to you? Just saying
no,
right now,
not
it
at
does
all.
Not.
Yeah, that's Wisp, though.
He got the cogs up, which means everyone else just can't run in, but they Finger of Death and Avalanche him out.
They tried to rescue him with Wisp, but he just got blown up too quickly.
They could try and fortify the tower and buy a little bit more time here, but yeah, Ferrari's moving into position. He's going to get sealed up if they want to try and save FY, but FY being tossed up and thrown down. And that's a double kill now for the Tiny. More injection of money. Up to 1700 gold right now on this Tiny. After buying that BKB moments ago, now the tier 2 tower. He's getting bottled up for the moment. He's going to hold on to his toss as he gets concussive as well as orb down a little bit, but as you can see, he doesn't really care about this. The damage output is not scary enough for him to really do anything about it. But the Nagas want to come and join this fight, but might have to. The Brewmaster jumps in, goes to split the seals over on the Doombringer, and they do get their Mythic Flare off. Clockwork, hook shots over to Ferrari, the cogs go down. It's just controlling where he has to run to while the ensnare's going to be used too. They're going to burn the 10 second BKB, so they kited him out. The toss will happen, but while Riptide, I kind of just want to watch Ferrari. He's the main man they want to bring down. June, he gets one Horp Stomp. Black got to back himself up, but the Avalanche connects on 3. The Nagas sleep, they need more speed to reach him. 4-3-1 versus 4-3-2 is just not enough. The Naga Sleep will not catch the Tiny. June will blink himself away to safety. And IG at the end of that, well, they lose two heroes. And that's all. They'd still took the tier 2 tower on bottom lane.
It actually got denied too, so that was definitely in VG's favor. Even if the best thing, if they could have saved Naga Sleep right there, I think they could have taken Roshan off of that potentially. If they would have gone straight to it and had Naga Sleep to protect it, but I'm sure they're still very happy with that outcome.
And because of this now, Blank goes back to his own farming up in the Dire Jungles where he should be heading to, but Super is currently farming up most of that. And it's all being watched by these Observer Wards, which are being planted down by Invictus Gaming. So they know when Naga Siren is just farming up inside the jungle or when she's vulnerable. So that top lane is Ice. Hexed up. And then, well, follow-up stun. He did get the mech charge off, but it just stalls up his death by a grand total of 1 second. Ferrari is chasing down to FY. He'll have to tether himself away. The Observer Ward sees him. He'll get stunned up and actually getting hit and getting control up on the high ground. Ferrari, maybe super. Now he'll be tossed over. The Ants clump a bubble. This will slow down Ferrari. BKB could have been triggered from Ferrari if things got a little rough. But he drum charged to try and chase that kill. And then now, Blink into the toss of the Centaur. What a combination.
My path is
Chu knew he couldn't make it by himself, so he just blinked to Ferrari and allowed for the toss with the Observer on top of the hill. They had the perfect vision of what they wanted to do. That was poetry in motion.
Yep. Fiji should know about that word now. That just happened, I think. I think they were pretty confident it was there already. Like, he was going to deward it, but they should know for sure.
Doom Ringer now is a Blink Dagger.
Here's a relocate. We haven't really seen very many relocating, have we?
They're coming up to the top, and now he gets Doomed up instantly, and the tether got separated.
Wow.
This is a bit of a balls up. They'll be able to kill off Chissbug right now, and now moving over towards the Doombringer. They're actually getting trapped up for the moment. And Skywrath Mage is sent up in the air. Tiny is basically off the clockwork. They're moving up to the top lane. The blink away by Luo. And he'll turn. The Brewmaster coming back to his normal self. We'll get one last stun to combine it with the Mystic Flare and the Clamp. So they bring down the Doombringer again. But Fenrir trying to battle up against Ashley. Sean's going to kill him off with the Urn Charge. And Super, well, no Clamp for you. The Tiny will finally pump him down. It is a 14-04 Tiny, but Black is pushing the bottom lane. And this Tiny is so big. A 14-04. Ferrari hasn't died, man. This Tiny is massive. And not as you can see, grows.
Yeah, he is getting the kills he needs with his BKB, that's for sure. I mean, he can still do a ton of damage on single targets if he gets, you know, just standard damage items. He doesn't really need the Ags. It just makes his ability to kill towers, like, stupid crazy. So, with this much armor on Tiny, he can potentially just, like, base push if he gets... I mean, I think he's going to get, like, an AC probably, and then... I think you still just go basically the standard Tiny build, but, you know, you just skip the Ags. I don't think he even gets it at this point. Okay, he finishes Manta, which... probably good. Yeah, I guess he doesn't really have the inventory space for another item besides that right now, so he should finish that first and just save his money.
Once he gets himself to a point where he's happy to sell the bottle.
Yeah, that's probably next to go, and I think he just wants an AC so he has like a little bit more pushing power, because then like he doesn't really need the Ags if you have Manta AC, right? You just destroy the towers with your illusions and the AC aura.
That's true. I don't know if I'm still a fan of seeing Tiny without an Aghanim Scepter, because it's really uncommon.
Yeah, it's just so... Sometimes it's so normal to see items, though, that you just think of it as second nature, but... I mean, he still can farm with his nukes, and he has been fighting so much that he doesn't really need to farm. I mean, he's 14-0, so he doesn't really need the creep kills, necessarily. As long as he's able to keep getting kills, he's perfectly happy with that, instead of killing creeps. And he can still, like I just said, you know, combo the creep waves and just kill them anyways. It just slows it down a little bit because you can't, like... You can only farm every 17 seconds, or, like, I guess every 9 seconds with Toss, as opposed to... They're actually smoking right here, and they have a Haste on Tiny. This is sure to be another kill.
Yeah, Super's gonna get caught out. Doomed up, Hexed up, and then they just run in on him. Tossing an Avalanche from the Tiny. He actually held onto the Haste Rune for that as well. So he didn't have to expend it while Black... You notice what he does? The second he realizes they're coming at him, he just sent one illusion down middle lane to just push it a little bit. And goes for the creep skip. Oh, Skywrath Mage. Oh, Skywrath. That's behind the tier 2 tower. You end up dying. But Black has just started the split push. So if IG do really want to try and push out the tier 2 tower or look to, on either the top or the mid, they're going to have to deal with the pushing power from also Ice on the top lane. But the Naga Siren coming into the tier 3 tower on the bottom. Yeah, Black's going to search for the trade-off. Mirror images. And it looks like IG are giving it to him at the moment. Chuan's going to be the first one to TP back. But this isn't going to be the easiest fight in the world for him. Now, 4-star into a Hoof Stomp. And then Ice caught in the tree line. Attempted relocate save again. From Dyer's FY, out of position, and he's going to be coming straight back to this. Ferrari sitting right on top of the spot. Super, blink, clap, he didn't get a split off! The stun came out from Chisberg, and now Super throwing his own life away. FY on the sidelines, Black comes in and will let the Naga Sleep go. Jude's the one that's being controlled. Ferrari in the meantime though is just sitting inside the base killing off the Skywrath Mage. Mike's the only sole survivor. They get the ensnare off onto Ferrari. It looks like with the Riptide as well, it's not going to be enough damage to kill off anybody here. And Invictus Gaming will take almost a full team wipe, a tier 2 tower, and not lose a single hero.
That was crazy. I mean, this is like a game of when like Whispery locates go wrong. That's two times now where they lost pretty significant fights because like someone gets blown up by the lion before they can do, or not the lion that time, but it was just like the first time was lion. It just all their nuke damage in general. They just die before the Wisp can relocate them out, and like Wisp is basically worthless at that point because he just comes back and gets killed immediately. I think what happened there, actually, I'm not honestly completely sure, but he, like, the panda blinked in and got tossed by the tiny because the tiny was just waiting for the Wisp to come back. So he, like, blinked in and he was just, like, spamming it. And it was as soon as he came in, he just tossed the panda because he blinked right on top of him. And then they just comboed him.
The first thing I saw, and the toss might have been there, my tight eyes might have just missed it. Ice hookshot in. He's going to go for June at the moment. I thought for a moment June would just get himself away to safety, but, well, with the BKB, he stands, seals, and then runs up for the avalanche toss combination. The supports just pop. Ferrari, this guy is 19-07. Like, he's got 19 out of the 30 kills of Invictus Gaming. If they ever kill him off, it'll be like,
yeah.
I actually think this is the biggest streak I've cast in a very long time. Vici Gaming also dropped the gem during that engagement too. But I actually don't think I've seen a 19-0 streak in Dota for at least like 6 months. This is just ridiculous. How much money is this guy worth if they can kill him? Dire's top
tower is under attack. I don't think they can kill him. That's the problem. He's so farmed at this point and so tanky because of his levels. Like,
oh, they're ganking bottom lane. Potentially kill Courier. In fact, Blast's going to kill off Courier as well as going for Chuan. He'll TP out. Because he uses Snare, he has to use Sleep to cancel the TP out. That was the only option he had, but now there's no Sleep while the rest of Invictus Gaming are breaching high ground. The Cogs will keep him out a little bit. And the Whisperers will drag the creep wave back, but there's a new one coming and the catapult's still alive. Now Black, Illusions in, Clockwork, Knight's Hookshot, they got the seal over on Doombringer, so there's no Doom in this fight, but Ferrari stands. How much can he deliver though? There's BKB for protection, they want to bring him down, now he triggers Mana Style, so there's more Ferrari, but he is going to go down, he's too low on life, they bring him down. 13-7-1 is how much he is worth. The Tiny Enchantress are gone, and Invictus Gaming, I think they may have overextended themselves here. Chizbug trying to escape, a TP out in time, I think they have enough damage, yeah they do. Four heroes lost for Invictus Gaming, including the big man. VG Gaming also with the kill on the Enchantress on the bottom lane and the Courier. They got a huge injection of money, a huge injection of experience, and they needed it. They were 25k behind in experience and 12k behind in gold. They needed something like that to keep themselves alive.
Yep. They really need to get Naga 16 so they can just use Sleep more aggressively. I mean, that was still a really good Sleep bottom because they killed Enchantress and got the gem out of it, and then obviously they got that fight off the back of it, but if they can use Sleep more often, that'll be really good for them because they can use it whenever like a BKB is popped, an individual BKB, and then they just net that guy and then kill him. So it'll help make their team fight so much stronger as soon as Naga gets 16, and I mean, at this point of the game, it's not like IG's in a position to really pressure end the game before he's going to get 16. So Black is, and he's also pretty farmed, like he got a lot of gold out of that fight and out of like all the farming he's been doing. I think, actually is, does he go heart or does he just get a, like, yeah, we were talking about this the other day.
He needs heart in this game, mainly just because of the burst damage combo that comes from IG. We're going to relocate Gank down the bottom lane. Chuan again, he just seems to be the man that they can catch out of position. And, well, Mystic Flare committed as well.
Yeah, it takes like four of them to kill like the weakest person on IG's team, but that's what they need to do. Oh, they're back here, wait for it.
It's a trap! Black goes down, and so does Wisp, and blink away by Super. Holds the Shiva's guard for now. The Courier is visible with the Observer Ward, and it's over the tree line. Shoot! Ah! The VG Gaming branded Courier stays alive for now, but
Ferrari
comes high ground.
So I don't think they can afford to give up a Rex, so I would be very surprised if they don't buy back and defend this. I mean, they're just waiting for the right moment. Ice is getting ready to go, I think.
There's the buyback by the Naga Siren. Super. Actually, got, did he just get hit then? Because he triggered the Shiva's guard, but never blinked himself all the way in. And now the Naga Sleep catching up three heroes, ice, needs the perfect cogs, and while he doesn't get anybody with it, the BKBs will come up. Ferrari now does trigger his June, trying to turn the Broomlings on the front lines. He can stand now. Clockwork hook shots himself in. There is no follow-up, however, and the Broomlings, well, two of them are gone, at least the Fireball, one of them, sorry, the Firebrewling is gone. Black gonna get doomed up, finger to death as well. He doesn't have a lot of life points to take it up, but it will be enough, as also the mech will come in. Chispuck flies over towards the site, being chased down by the Sky Wraith mates. He'll go down to that. Black does finally take a fall, but now the cogs, really nice lock in. They need more damage, and they got it too. Tiny, as well as the Centaur, locked inside of that super. Blink in 6 seconds, but just getting the movement speed for now. But the Doombringer is able to get his blink taken back off cooldown. Concussive shot slowing him down. The buyback came out from the Centaur, but Luo is already down. Super with the double kill. That Brewmaster really working overtime. And it's amazing how susceptible IG are to this ganking power of VG Gaming. They found another one too. The Shiva's guard slowing him down. Relocate. Fenrir comes in. Chuan forced after away. The hookshot's going to be off target. Still sealed up, but there's more orb damage with the spirits coming in too. Concussive shot still on cooldown. And June trying to back up the clap 1 second. They're going to slow him down a second time now. Ice is going to come in range, but now Cogs keeps June away from Super. He's trying to TP out this one. The 10th win, they don't have the damage output required to kill him off. VG Gaming have chased from their tier 3 tower to Invictus Gaming's tier 2 tower after all of these kills. And the buybacks being used, one from the Centaur, one from the Naga Siren. And that is all.
They're pinging out Roche. Yeah, Black needs to get 16 before he uses his next ult. He had to use it there, obviously, but and also the gem's still down in mid. Hopefully, I'm sure that VG will eventually pick that up. They're gonna get Roche right here. I don't think there's any way that IG can contest this in time.
How is VG Gaming really able to get through the Centaur on the Tiny like that? The BKBs went off, Isis cracked him inside the pit, and then they just nailed him.
Yeah, the Panda is so good against Tiny once he gets his, once the Tiny's BKB falls off, because he just drunken haze him and he does like no damage. So he needs to get. He probably needs to get MKB as his next item on Ferrari. As much as we want to see those big crits.
Naga Sleep right now. Blast got to protect his teammates, but then again, he can't do it because the BKB's already up. Fenrir stunned up inside the pit, but he's actually invis in here because they don't see him. He's got a Mystic Glare available, and now he's going to drop a Ferrari. His BKB will protect him. Black Finger of Death, they can't get him out of here. The Aegis Immortal will trigger. Super's on the sideline. Ice will join him as Ferrari gets another kill. Orb stop and relocate save out. Third time lucky, F5 will succeed. And without holding Black alive, then that could have actually been a GG. So that's a big relocate save for FY. He'll go back solo to die. And they wait for him. The Horf stomp.
Wait,
what?
Black with.
Why do you bring Black? Oh, why? No. Ferrari!
Why? Great. That's no buyback. I actually, like, didn't see
mistake?
What he just did.
He didn't have the tether on.
That was a
on.
Guaranteed mistake. There's no way that was the right play.
He tethered him at the last moment.
I think he was trying to. I have no idea. I don't even know. I need to like go watch the replay for that or something. That was obviously.
That's game. That's actually game winning move. Or game losing move and GG.
I mean, it was still a really bad situation for them after that Roche fight, but they had a chance. Yeah. But yeah, that's super game over now.
Well, Invictus Gaming. They are one victory away from being crowned the Cena Cup finalists. After VG Gaming may have had a big fall from grace.